So much promise, and with so much on the line, sometimes promise cannot be fulfilled. For Rick DiPietro, he knew it worst of all. The New York Islanders drafted the young DiPietro in 2000, but neither the Islanders or DiPietro could know what the future had in store. DiPietro was born in Winthrop, Massachusetts in September of 1981. At a young age, he knew what he wanted to be, a hockey goalie. By age 5, he was in love with the game. His father, a war veteran, taught him the honor and sacrifice that would stay with him for the rest of his life. Growing up, his favorite goalies were Andy Moog, Mike Richter, and of course, Ron Hextall. DiPietro attended Boston University. He won a ton of honors and accolades, such as the co-MVP of Hockey East and the MVP of the Beanpot, the Boston Tournament of University Teams. He would leave his school in his freshman year to be drafted in the 2000 NHL Draft.
The New York Islanders are picking Rick DiPietro, a goaltender from Boston University, as the number one pick.
You guys go over the tape.
Well, there you have it. History in the making, announced by Sanjay Kumar, one of the two new owners of the New York Islanders.
The New York Islanders has selected Rick DiPietro from Winthrop.
In 2000-2001, he would be sent down to the American Hockey League for the Chicago Wolves. The young goalie would try to attempt to learn how to survive in the pro game. Eventually, he did make his NHL debut in January of 2001. He'd have an ugly start to his season, an ugly season overall. Getting his first win in February, he posted an NHL worst 3 wins, 15 losses, 1 tie in that first year with a 3.49 goals against average. Spend part of the 2001-2 season and part of the 2002-3 season with the Bridgeport Sound Tigers of the AHL. Eventually, he would be called up and be quite formidable for the New York Islanders. As soon as DiPietro started to succeed in 2003-04, he sputtered down a bit and had arthroscopic knee surgery at the end of the season and before the NHL lockout. After the lockout, DiPietro helped Team USA in the World Championships, putting him in a position to be treated as an elite goaltender and received a lot of praise from around the NHL. DiPietro in 2006 would make a decision that would change his life and the NHL overall forever, signing a 15-year, $67.5 million contract. He'd have a good season to end 2006-07, but the money was pretty crazy. Can he really be durable was a lot of the questions. In 2007-08, he made a total of 63 starts and posted a 2.82 goals against. Pretty good, but not the standard of a 15-year contract. In 2009, the New York Islanders would lay the groundwork for their future. Their first overall pick that year was a kid from Mississauga with skill and leadership. Also, they found a diamond in the rough in the minor leagues.
Jackman, nice feed to Tavares. Great move, another great move, he scores! What a play!
Molson to Parento. Parento away from Martinez. Down low, Molson scores! What a play by Matt Molson! His second of the game!
Continued getting work done on his left knee and missed the majority of the beginning of the season, and then right knee swelling may have missed the majority of the end of the season. In 2010-11, Rick DiPietro had a good start but had to go on injury reserve after swelling and tendonitis grew in his left knee. He returned to the lineup after an infamous situation as he played the Pittsburgh Penguins on February 2nd, 2011. The opposing goalie, Brent Johnson, decided to fight DiPietro in a brawl-filled penalty fest of a game. DiPietro got punched and fractured his face. He missed the next 20 games and ended his season. Luck wouldn't help DiPietro. In 2011, he suffered a concussion by taking a puck to the mask during a practice. He later got a hernia in the same season, ending his season. In 2012-13, he played in Germany during the lockout. He played for SC Riese Z. He ended up hurting his groin and missing the rest of that German season. He returned to the New York Islanders on opening night, where he'd be booed by fans. DiPietro was waived and sent back to the Bridgeport Sound Tigers. Now he is trying to reclaim the ranks in the NHL.